We already know that a user is anyone who's logging into Salesforce. But something that we haven't touched on is how licenses fit into all of this. We've mentioned licenses quite a bit, so let's get to the bottom of it. The most important thing that you really need to know is that every user must have a license of some type. That's the golden rule. But let's start this with an analogy that I find really helpful when trying to understand licenses in Salesforce. Imagine buying Salesforce for your company like you're buying a car for yourself. The first thing that you need to decide is what kind of car you're looking for. Are you looking for something super flash with all the bells and whistles, all the latest features, like, you know, the Tesla, the Ferrari, the Rolls Royce of cars? Or are you just looking for something that gets you from point A to point B? A little mini or a scooter with just the basics would be fine. This is exactly the same for choosing which edition of Salesforce you want. Do you want to spend heaps of money on a full kitted out edition of Salesforce with all of the awesome new features, all of the tools, maximum functionality, or do you just need something that covers the basics? Salesforce has four editions that you can choose from. These are Essentials, Professional, Enterprise, and Unlimited. And Essentials is the most basic, covering literally just the essentials, and Unlimited would be the most expensive, which covers pretty much everything you could possibly need from Salesforce. Once you've decided on your edition of Salesforce, you then need to purchase a range of Salesforce licenses so people at your company can actually use Salesforce. Remember, every user who logs into Salesforce must have one license. This is just like assigning a license for a car. You can only get in the car and drive the car if you have a license. Now, in Salesforce, like cars, not all licenses are created equal. You have learner's licenses, you have full licenses for cars, and the same is for Salesforce. In fact, Salesforce has more than 11 different types of licenses, with more constantly being created. Each type of license lets you do different things in Salesforce and is priced appropriately. For example, if you have a license that lets users write articles or update photos, then you're going to pay a lot less than a license which lets users access all the standard and custom objects in Salesforce. The range of licenses available also depends on which edition of Salesforce that you have. If we think back to that car metaphor, imagine that you have a Tesla and then you have a license that lets the driver use the self-driving feature. Awesome, sounds great. But there's not much point in having that license if you've just got a scooter with no self-driving feature. It just is pointless. And the same goes for Salesforce licenses. Let's take a look at three of the most common user licenses in Salesforce. These are the ones that you're most likely to come across. The first is the standard Salesforce license. It's easily the most popular license as it grants access to pretty much everything in Salesforce. Almost all your users are going to be on this, your Salesforce admins, your average sales users, the whole bunch. Our second type of license is the developer license, which grants access to developer sandboxes, but limits what they can do in the actual live production org. It's obviously designed specifically for developers who are building things more than they're actually using the end side of Salesforce. The third type of license that we have here is what we call a knowledge-only user license, which lets users access articles, they can write chats and chatter, and they can create custom objects, but they're not really using the standard side of Salesforce, things like opportunities or leads. You can find information about which licenses you have in Salesforce by going to the Systems Overview page or the Company Information page in Setup. But what are all of these licenses that you're seeing there? You're not just seeing the licenses that we've talked about, there's also feature licenses and permission set licenses. What are these? Well, on top of everything that we've already covered, the icing on the cake is that Salesforce also has one final layer of licenses. These are our feature licenses and our permission set licenses. A feature license gives a user access to additional features that are not included in their current user license. It's like a little add-on to what their license already has. Permission set licenses are almost identical to feature licenses. Very, very similar. but they give you an extra level of control over who exactly gets this additional access. Because as if there wasn't already enough licenses and enough security going around, you can now also check if a user has the right permission set license to actually use a permission set that they've been assigned. If you don't know what a permission set is, don't worry, we're covering that later on as well. You can view all of your company's feature licenses and permission set licenses by going to Company Information and Setup and then looking at the related lists. Just scroll down on your page a bit to see those. If you want to give a feature license or a permission set license to a user, you can do this from the user account page. Remember that a user can have multiple feature and permission set licenses, but only one actual normal license. So, if you're buying Salesforce, the total cost that you want to be thinking about in terms of licenses and additions is made up like this. First, you have the addition that you choose. Second, you have the user licenses that you select. Third, any feature licenses that you decide to add on, or any permission set licenses that you want to add. All of this is just money in the bank for Salesforce and a little bit of a headache for us.